When you create a Py tag, that tag is going to have certain default values for some of its attributes. So for example, if we take a look at the attributes for archive, things like 0, span, etc., those are going to default. And they're going to default in ways that may not work very well for that tag. For example, especially with the exception and compression deviation, the defaults are something you should be aware of. Now, here's the tag CDT158. It's already had its exception and compression and its 0 and span set appropriately. But when I create a brand new tag, just choose new here, what you'll notice is you get these defaults. The 0 is 0 and the span is 100. Your exception and compression deviation always default to 1 engineering unit and 2 engineering units for compression and for compression deviation. So this is something to keep in mind because for some of your instrumentation, that's probably not going to work out very well. I mean, for example, think of this compression deviation for a temperature transmitter, for example. That means that you'd need a change of 2 degrees before we would store it in the archive. Well, obviously, for very large tanks, etc., 2 degrees is an enormous change. You would want something much less, so something like, you know, 0.1 or something like that, 1/10 of 1 degree. So be careful when you do set or build these tags that your exception and compression deviation are set appropriately. And also, we do mention 0 and span at the same time, because if you are setting your exception and compression using percent of span, then what you choose for your span ends up becoming very important. A very large span here where your exception and compression is set for percent of span will end up perhaps giving you results that you didn't anticipate. Now, how can you tell as an end user that you're looking at a tag that's got exception and compression set improperly? Well, here's one thing I suggest people do. Just take a look at a trend, and if you see data that kind of looks like this, where you get a tremendous amount of detail, and that detail is really something that's of no interest to you. You're really just interested in kind of the overall trend. That's probably something that's got it's gathering too much data, so the exception and compression are too small. On the other hand, if you end up seeing only, oh, let's say, for example, a value here, and then another value here, and then another value up here, and you're not really seeing as much data as you would normally see on your control system, that would be an indication where the exception and compression deviation may be set too broadly.